Hello friends, welcome to this video on circles. In the previous video, we discussed about chords and their distances from the center. Today, we will solve some questions related to the same. Let's start with our first question. In the given figure, the center is O. And the radius is 8 cm and the length of the chords XY and PQ is given to be 12 cm. Then find the length of OS and OT. Friends, they are given that the radius of the circle is 8 cm. That is, if we join OY and OQ in such a way, then you can see that these are the radii of the circle. So, OY and OQ will be equal to 8 cm. We are given that the length of XY is 12 cm. According to the figure, we can say that XY is formed by joining XS and SY and OS is perpendicular to XY. We know that the perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord bisects the chord. So, XS and SY will be equal. This means SY will be equal to 1 by 2 XY, from which we will obtain SY as 6 cm. Friends, look at the figure carefully. If we look at the triangle OSY, then this is a right angle triangle. And we know the length of the side SY and the hypotenuse OY. Using the Pythagoras theorem here, we can easily find the length of OS here. Pause the video and try yourself. We obtain the length of OS as 2 root of 7 cm. Now we have to find the length of OT. According to the figure, OT is the perpendicular from the center of the circle to chord PQ. According to the question, XY and PQ are equal chords, and we know that equal chords of a circle are at equal distance from the center. Therefore, the length of OT will also be 2 root of 7 cm. Similarly, we found the lengths of OS and OT. Let's move forward and solve one more question. In the given figure, a circle whose center is O, its radius is 10 cm, and the chords AB and PQ are situated 6 cm away from the center of the circle. Then, find the length of chords AB and PQ. Friends, in the figure, if we join the center O and point B, then we obtain OB, which is the radius of this circle. And we are given that the radius of the circle is 10 cm. So, OB will be equal to 10 cm. And we are also given that chord AB is situated at 6 cm from the center of the circle. That is, OM is perpendicular to chord AB whose length is 6 cm. Friends, now look at this right angle triangle OMB, where OB is the hypotenuse and we know the length of OB and OM. Using the Pythagoras theorem over here, we can easily find the length of side MB. Pause the video and try to find it yourself. Friends, we have obtained the length of side MB as 8 cm. Now look at the figure. Line segment OM is perpendicular to chord AB. And we know that a perpendicular line drawn from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Therefore, AM and MB will be equal. So, the length of AM will also be 8 cm. And we can write chord AB as AM plus MB. Placing the length of AM and MB here, we obtain AB as 16 cm. Friends, note that we are given that chord PQ is also situated at the same distance from the center as chord AB. So, the two chords are situated at an equal distance from the center. So, the length of chord PQ will be 16 cm. Because we know that equidistant chords from the center of a circle are equal in length. In this way, we found the length of both the chords AB and PQ. Friends, if in this figure only we draw a chord CD whose length is 14 cm and a chord EF whose length is 18 cm, then which chord will be closest to the center and which will be farthest? We know that the closer we move to the center, the length of the chord increases, but their distance from the center decreases. Just by looking at the figure only, you can say that chord EF, which is the largest chord, will be the closest to the center, and chord CD, which is the shortest, will be the farthest from the center. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we solved some questions related to chords and their distances from the center. See you in the next video. Thank you.